when COVID-19 occurs, many economic issues arise. Because COVID-19 is easily transmitted and contagious, many businesses are implementing the Movement Control Order, or also known as MCO. The Movement Control Order MCO, which the government announced in 2020, has prohibited closed state activities and closed business premises unless services are necessary and the natural resource sector is available. In addition, this pandemic has also changed the pattern of household spending, where priorities are given to personal and family survival expenses to meet basic needs such as food and drinks. Malaysia and the United States are among the countries facing economic issues. So, what are the issues?
We're 6 months into this pandemic, and what we're seeing is that it's really something that's unprecedented. We've seen huge drops in consumer spending, which in turn has impacted small businesses, which in turn has impacted employment.
The purchasing power of Malaysian households is indirectly reflected in inflation as measured by the Consumer Price Index. For the year 2020, overall CPI in Malaysia is 120.1, which is lower 1.4 compared to the year before. Based on CPI 2020 study, the buying power of household consumption in Malaysia recorded 83.3%, down 16.7% over a 10-year period. Two groupings of goods and services, communication 102.6%, clothing and footwear 100%, recorded purchasing power of more than 100% among 12 major groups, which is 107%. This shows that compared to the 10 years earlier, households could afford to enjoy communication services, clothing and footwear. Alcoholic beverages and tobacco saw the greatest decline in purchasing power, down 40.6%. Restaurants and hotels 25.8%, foods and beverages 25.8% are next 34.5%. Declining demand for numerous goods, including a drop in the price of oil, probably the pandemic initially had low or negative inflation. Later, due to export limitations or a containment of supply from the manufacturers, the price of food and goods and services increased. Due to the large number of layoffs and resulting income losses and reduction, purchasing power also decreased. The demand for goods and services, as well as their sales and profitability, have declined as a result.
What are the causes of inflation in Malaysia? Social incarceration and limited operating hours of business premises have resulted in a decline in revenue for the food and beverage sector. Although price increases for raw materials happen, traders in this industry only raises prices for ready meals cooked at a low rate to maintain profits. It can be translated through the index for the food outside subgroup, which recorded an increase lower at 1.7% compared to 3.3% in 2019. This is in line with prices increases for items in the food at home subgroups such as vegetables, fish and meat. So, what action is Malaysia taking to overcome this inflation problem? Malaysia overcomes the problem of inflation by using monetary policy. The Malaysian government also introduced various other initiatives such as a moratorium on loan repayments and wage subsidies to ensure that employers can retain employees.
We'll explain to you about unemployment rate in Malaysia. Due to COVID-19 pandemic in year 2020, the unemployment rate increased from 1.2 percentage point to 4.5 percentage point. This is mean The number of unemployed people in Malaysia due to COVID-19 pandemic increased 39.9% or 202,800 to 711,000. This can be seen in the term age of group. The unemployment rate for youth 15 years old to 24 years old increased 18,200 people. This is a quite large number and a proof that many people in Malaysia affected by the COVID-19. So, what are the reasons for unemployment rate increase in Malaysia due to pandemic COVID-19? There are two reasons, and the first major reason is increase in labor cost and decrease in revenue. And second reason is because there are many factors that cannot operate normally unless the sectors are allowed by the government. By the causes that been explained just now, there are two effects of unemployment due to pandemic COVID-19. The firstly, the increase in poverty in Malaysia. And second, is the loss of national output. For increase in poverty, under the situation unemployment, the man will have no source of income. When the man have no source of income, the poverty will increase. This is because the debt burden will grow and economic will worsen. This can be seen in the year 2020, 8.4% increase for poverty rate. For the loss of national output, when the labor resources cannot be used fully, the production cannot be at the highest peak. So, the workforce are limited, and the potential for loss of income and output increase. So, what other solution can be taken? Under the leadership of Prime Minister, Malaysia are given two incentives which given by the government. The first is Jamin Kerja and the second is MyStep. What is Jamin Kerja incentive? Jamin Kerja incentive are functioning to encourage employer to employ unemployed person and vulnerable groups such as ex-convict, senior citizen and disabled person. The employer will be given 20% bonuses for first 6 months and 30% bonuses will be given if they pay more than 1,500 per month. For MyStep incentive, it is a short-term work placement program which been introduced in budget 2021. There are 80,000 contract jobs that been allocated and there are 50,000 which allocated for public sectors and 30,000 for GLCs. So, by the solutions that are being given by the government, this solution will decrease the unemployment rate in Malaysia that been affected due to COVID-19.
In March 2020, the start of pandemic initial outbreak in the United States, the COVID-19 CPI inflation estimated higher than official CPI, although both showed mitigation. The COVID-19 CPI arose because of the impact of changing in expenditure pattern because of the COVID-19 pandemic. As the pandemic grew, the difference between two inflation rates increased. The official CPI fell 0.69% between March and April, compared to COVID-19 CPI, which decreased only 0.09%. Also, in May 2020, the official CPI experienced deflation, whereas the COVID-19 CPI had a positive inflation. The COVID-19 outbreak of 2020 created awareness among financial media, academics, bankers regarding to the challenge of measuring infection during a COVID-19. The COVID-19 pandemic has led to lockdown, mobility restriction and social distancing rules that changed consumers' expenditures in many countries. In particular, the consumers spend more on food and non-alcoholic, housing, health and miscellaneous, and spend less on the transportation, hotels and recreation. The change in consumers' expenditures caused a higher inflation. This is due to the strict lockdown policy implemented by the US government. The expenditures percentage were different before and during the pandemic. The change in expenditure percentage came into the significant bias in measuring the consumer's price index used to measure inflation in the United States. Due to the pandemic, most countries that are affected by the COVID-19 also have a problem supplying the product and material, such as China. China had to shut down a factory because it enforced a very strict movement control. Based on the situation, they cannot produce and supply the product or material to the United States. Apart from that, the USA cannot supply goods and services to consumers and business. During the pandemic, the United States also had a problem with the flow of goods coming from abroad, in particular through the port of Los Angeles. The problem with the flow of goods coming from abroad is long lines of cargo ship lined up to get into the port of Baltimore. So that is a distribute to the supplying of stuff coming particularly from the Far East because of the way they respond to the pandemic. This situation affects the supply of goods, which caused the push on demand, and those two things tend to push price up. The United States controls inflation by using monetary policy. Monetary policy, which consists of controlling the supply of money by the central bank, is enforced by using the different monetary instruments which aim to reduce the supply of money. Monetary policy is the most important policy to manage inflation. To limit the economic impact of lockdown and shutdown during the pandemic, the federal government sets a government security for government debt management. The sales of government security by the federal government caused a fall in the price security and reduced the supply of money. The federal government also purchased the government security after the market liquidity became implemented and initial motivation has restored market function. This can increase the money supply that attempt to stimulate the economy to the highest economic growth.
The unemployment rate rose during the most recent recession from 3.5% in February 2020 to 4.4% in March 2020 before reaching a high of 14.8% in the final month of the recession. The first point of effect is difficulty covering household expenses. The number of adults who struggle to pay for typical household expenses like food, rent or mortgage, auto payments, medical bills or student loans was revealed by the Household Cost Survey. According to statistics gathered between September 29 and October 11, 2021, 63 million adults or 29% of adults in the country said it had been somewhat or very difficult for their household to cover regular expenses in the previous week. That decreased from a peak of 38% in the middle of December 2020. Next is about cost of unemployment in United States of America. Facts and studies indicate that there are numerous variables that may be connected to the USA's unemployment rate. First off, the rising labor expenses and declining profit are the main contributors to unemployment in the USA. For a variety of reasons, it is challenging to predict a business thriving without the possibility of economic stability. It becomes clear why when COVID-19 causes the USA's unemployment rate to rise. Due to this problem, they frequently cut back on staff to prevent drastic increases in operating expenses. Government incentive. The Families First Coronavirus Response Act, which was President Trump signed into law on March 18, 2020, gives state unemployment insurance agency more freedom and more administrative funds to address the COVID-19 outbreak. As we all know, during early stages of COVID-19, the government had introduced Movement Control Order, or MCO, where all sectors were forced to be closed. When the COVID-19 cases started to reduce, the US government had made the decision to reopen all economic sectors stage by stage. Hence, this would decrease the rate of unemployment in the US because it gives opportunity for unemployed workers to get themselves in the industry.
To sum up our presentation, the differences of rate of inflation and unemployment between countries shows that every circumstance due to COVID-19 crisis needs to be measured precisely by the government and people before making decisions. In this situation, we can really see how people can cooperate with the government to overcome the crisis, and what decisions have been made by the government to overcome the inflation and reduce unemployment rate. As we all know, inflation has historically been inversely related to unemployment. This means that as inflation rises, so does unemployment. Lower inflation is associated with higher unemployment. When more people work, they have more spending power, which leads to an increase in demand. By listing all solutions that have been stated, unemployment and inflation can be overcome and the economy of the country can be healed.